We are coming to you live from the Republic Broadcasting Network, where you can handle the truth. Good evening from Boston, Massachusetts. My name is Frank Allen. Tonight, Marilyn from Ohio and I discuss our targeting on TM Radio. But first, joining Targeted Massachusetts is free. Just go to targetedmassachusetts.org and in the navigation, go to contact information. Please complete the easy registration form. By joining, you receive our newsletter, text updates, and the latest developments in our situation. Donate to Targeted Massachusetts and help us to continue our activism. We are a legal organization in the state of Massachusetts. If you have any doubts about anything or any questions, call me anytime in the U.S. at 1-508-857-8334. Call into the show live and ask a question at 800-313-9443, or you can listen at 605-313-0163. Targeted Massachusetts Northeast Conference airs Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays at 9 p.m. Eastern. Access by phone, 515-604-9715. Access code, 708-922. ID, targeted. If you'd like to join us by computer, in your address bar, type freeconferencecall.com/wall/targeted. I know you've probably listened to Kevin Annett on our show. He's been a guest, probably half a dozen times. If you'd like to listen to his radio show, it's Kevin Annett Live every Sunday at 6 p.m. Eastern at www.bbsradio.com/herewestand. Our YouTube channel is Targeted Massachusetts. We have a chat that accompanies this show, and it is at targetedmass.chatango.com. United Nations Special Rapporteur on Torture is to address no-touch torture in March 2020. This came from PAX International and Janet Phelan. And the no-touch torture part is accurate. What they don't go into are any attacks. So I have put in the chat the link to the questionnaire and also the link of the address to email it to when completed. Okay, Marilyn, are you on?
Hello, Frank. How are you?
Good. Well, I've been slammed around pretty good the last few days, but I'm hanging in there. How about you?
Same here, and I'm sorry to hear that you're being abused and tortured. And I can say that it's been, the last few days, it's been pretty brutal.
Yeah, it seems to be the norm around the community as well. Everybody is getting slammed, and I think it's because the perps are going into hyperdrive to try and scare us half to death or make up for lost time or something like that, because I think they're getting summarily booted one at a time or by website out of this. And we'll know this when we start hearing from targets that say suddenly that their targeting has dropped. And I can't wait to hear that.
Yeah, I can't wait to hear the first TI say, my targeting has stopped completely. I have heard many times TI say, it stopped. But once questioned by the community, they say, well, there's stalking. There's still vehicular stalking, or there's periodic sessions of tetanitis microwave torture. But a zero program, I have not heard that yet.
I think you will, because among those, I don't know, what is it up to, those indictments now? It started out at 50,000, and it went up out of sight. I don't know the exact number, but I think that pedophile that was actually committed suicide was one of those. So I think you're going to see a lot of people go down and a lot of large organizations go down. And with that is going to go the targeting. We've just received a new link to somebody in Air Force Command who was going to help us out. And
oh, okay, that's great.
Yeah, that is fantastic. Yeah, it really is. Boy, I chopped a whole piece out of here. I don't know where it went. But I was just going to say that we work with Targeted Justice, and Targeted Justice is a very fine organization. It was founded at the Unity and Hope Gathering in Massachusetts in 2017, and Midge Mathis made up her mind at this point in time that she had had enough. And so Targeted Justice was born. And we just came back from Washington, and that was a great time. And Marilyn, that's one that I was hoping you were going to make, but I don't even know the distance between Ohio and Washington at this point in time.
Yeah, that's a track. I do want to say that I did attend the Boston conference, and I met Midge. Beautiful woman, strong, very intelligent. And we're all very lucky to have her as a soldier for justice. That was one of the best events, to meet Matthew Aaron, members of PAX, and it was heavy targeting for a lot of us. Many of us did get tortured, so it was. It's great to stand up for yourself.
Yes, it is. No, my targeting at this point in time has been heavy mind games and heavy suggestions and heavy pushing towards suggestions. In other words, it feels like this thought is pushing against the side of my head and it's just not getting in. I just call it a big clump of gray that's trying to get in. And I just won't let it in. And sometimes you feel a thought that is definitely not your own. And they try and fake you out and reorder how they push the yes button and the no button. Have you gotten that experience that there is actually a positive yes or negative no button that they push?
Okay, well, having synthetic telepathy hive mind torture is it's pretty brutal. I can say that we are going through something very similar, and that's what I've been fighting for days, and it's just, worn me out where they're trying to pick every single detail to dominate my thoughts, my speech, and my actions. Like a puppet. And it's unacceptable. I do not consent. And so it's really important.
I do not consent either. I just had to sneak that in there. I'm sorry to interrupt you.
And the language of the mind, that this is a war of the mind. And whatever year of targeting you're in, day that you realize it, that they are in your mind. And I don't think it's fair for us to assume that there's a targeted individual who's not on a remote neural monitoring, that they may choose not to talk to you, but they may have someone just listen. They can also upload your thoughts and the images that you think of onto a computer. They can share it as a memory. For example, my torture right now is, it's about 20 people. Half of them torture me. The other half torture other people, or they're silent, or they observe. But on an everyday basis, it's 10 people just attacking me. And these are adults, white and black, male and female, gay and straight. And they are constantly trying to make me a zero. You know, one of the horrible commands that they do, and it's on a subliminal sound, is you forget. Well, for someone who's an aspiring comedic writer, you know, and an artist and a lover of poetry and culture, that's a horrible thing to do. A person that, you know, looked to be in the ranks with someone like Naomi, who's an activist, who exposed corruption. I'm having a hard time remembering her last name. She exposed the Milton Friedman, Chicago School, disaster capitalism, that my actual perps have been observing me for 7 years, and one of the white males had to remind me, because the other males are trying to tell me to forget my memories, forget me, forget who I am, and to adopt a beta sex slave servant to a poor class of people who were targeted and now have turncoated and now are stalkers. So they are constantly trying to dictate.
You have to ask them, you want what? Well, you want things right. That just aren't going to happen. You know, your memories are yours, and they can step on them, if you will, for a bit, we'll say. But they can't turn the switch off altogether and make you forget everything, because if they could do so, they would have by now. But they really make it miserable for me, because I'm a lover of literature and poetry and music, and they continually step on my memory. Like, if you hear me pause in the middle of a sentence, that means they have stood on me to the point where I cannot remember the next thought that I was going to bring up. And it's, I'm not sure how they do it, but I think it's fair that they break the connection, the mind-brain connection, or short it out, because the mind, to me, is energy. Mm-hmm. And I think that they are breaking the mind-brain link, because that's your data and your memories. Mm-hmm. And your mind is obviously your consciousness, and it's everything that makes you Marilyn, which I wouldn't
exactly
change.
And this is the first time that they've used memory as a form of torture. So, for instance, if I go shopping or I'm in a store and I look at something and I say, oh, look at that. And her name's Natasha Williams. She has my visual cortex. Give me an emotional feeling of the memory of that, what you're looking at, and I'm back at the age of 10 or 12. A lot of stuff, a lot of data that is, you know, just junk. It's junk memory. You know, that's what I just came up with, that, like, junk memory. But it developed my personality. And also, watching the television, I no longer can tolerate it. If I just flash through the television programs, Then she goes into, with the group, they take turns. Give me a feeling and a memory about what you're looking at. And I don't even know where that comes from, and I start to get anxiety, and they'll command panic attacks and then coughing. And I spoke with a TI. He's a wonderful man, and he said, yeah, it's MK Ultra programming. And so we get out the Bible today, and we read the Bible for a few minutes, you know, because you're going to have to really dig deep to survive something like this. You know, the sixth self-importance of Kettering, Ohio, that's where I'm located. These contract stalkers, they're abusing me. It's to murder me. It's forced suicide, or that I just collapse into a psychotic state and end up in a state hospital. Today I was shot with direct energies in my hands, in my legs, and then as I sat talking to you the first couple minutes, I was shot in the gut. And, you know, this goes on day or night. It doesn't matter where I am in the house, outside. And I know that you experienced that.
Yes, I do. Much the same. And there used to be people that would tell me, it's this, it's that. And I say, look, you can go out in the middle of the largest forest you can think of, naked, and you will still get this. And it will still haunt you, and it will still attack you, probably even worse. But they don't react the same when I take a shower. They turn into like somebody else. And I have like one perp that has, we'll say, three voices or so. And I have another perp that has nine. And I've caught them changing voices because they were really sloshed one evening. And they just switched from voice to voice to voice to voice to voice. And I said, oh, really? So I guess that explains that. There is not nine people. There are actually nine digitally sampled voices. So I learned that. And I think some people like yourself may have a lot of people that have actually joined this one particular hive mind, or have been sucked into it. And so you are actually dealing with a hive mind situation. So it's that we differ a little bit there, but it's still on the same track, though. I think there are a lot of different interpretations. Your interpretation may be off just a little bit, or it might be right on. But I think it's right on. Okay, thanks, Marilyn. I hear the commercial rattling off in the distance here. So thank you very much for listening. We'll be right back with Marilyn and Frank.
Folks, we're living in a world the likes of which we've never perceived any clearer than we do now. The plan for global governance has been in the works for generations and would have likely been achieved by now but for the fact that the globalists left open their Achilles heel. With all their tools, Federal Reserve System, fiat currency, No Child Left Behind, and then Common Core education introduced to our schools to dumb us down, vaccines, pharmaceuticals to lobotomize us, GMO foods, insertion of compromised or bought and paid for politicians, judges, mainstream media propaganda, all pieced together like a puzzle designed to ultimately bring the world under submission. But with all their strategy, they forgot one thing: knowledge. And knowledge is power. With knowledge, their bombardment is nullified. Folks, with that, as brilliant and knowledgeable as you've become, among the wisest audience of any radio audience in the world, and you are, I want you to take a moment to reflect and ask yourself, how much of that knowledge did I obtain from Republic Broadcasting Network? How high has my consciousness been raised since I've been a listener? How fast am I now able to discriminate truth from fake news by being a Republic Broadcasting listener? How clear am I now able to see the world since I've been listening to RBN? Ask yourselves those questions, folks. Then ask yourself, what is that knowledge worth to me? Like my morning coffee, how would I survive without it? A voice of truth in a sea of lies. Do we not all need to make sure it survives? Like public broadcasting, we are now finding we can only survive with listener support. Censorship, advertisers being attacked, truth itself being attacked. It's the only way through this. We at Republic Broadcasting humbly ask you to become a supporter. Look at your budget and make a determination of what Republic Broadcasting is worth to you and what you can afford on a monthly basis. Go to republicbroadcasting.org and pledge 20, 30, 40, 50, if possible, 100 a month or more if it's affordable. Click the donate button and become a regular monthly donor. Assure both us and yourself that Republic Broadcasting truth will continue to flow like that morning coffee. The network thanks you.
Don't regret growing old. It's a privilege denied to many. Heart disease is taking our youth from us. Young people in their 30s, 40s, 50s, and beyond are dying needlessly. One of the hardest messages I've ever had to deliver is to convince people that something natural like Extendivite should be taken as a preventative measure. I'm sure you heard, an ounce of prevention is worth a pound of cure. Extendivite is that ounce. Take Extendivite for 1 year and see what your doctor has to say and how much better you feel. Herbs take time to address the problem. It took years of life to have a problem. Give Extendivite 1 year to fix the problem. Don't wait until it's too late. Call 1-877-928-8822 or visit heartdrop.com or visit us on Amazon.
Extend your life with Extendivite.
Good evening from Boston, Massachusetts. My name is Frank Abbott. Tonight, Marilyn and I discuss our targeting on TM Radio. And due to the shortness of 1 hour, it goes like in 2 seconds, I'm going to get right back to Marilyn and we'll get going.
Okay, I wanted to share with your audience a really cool document that I got offline, a PhD, Mr. Marshall Thomas, and he used to work for the NASA Technical Department, and until discovering evidence on secret unlawful activities, he became a target of electronic harassment and was in a wheelchair. Now he can stand, he's rehabilitated, he's a musician. But he did these really excellent videos and posted them on YouTube to explain what he experienced. And this real-time mind reading that we're experiencing and thought broadcasting, where they can broadcast your thoughts and have others hear it. I experienced this. I'll give you an example of going to the Boston conference from Ohio in the car. In order to control my brain, I made up a song. And I sang it, and it looped because we have brain-to-computer interface. And we pull up into the Boston area, and I look to the right of me, and I see a woman, black woman, singing my song. And I said, well, that's impossible because this is not Top 40. I just made it up. And she had no idea that I was next to her. She was oblivious of my existence. But I have seen this, that they have implemented this global network of brain-to-brain communication without our consent. This is the top ticket item in any news media. If anyone's discussing anything else, either they're unaware of what's happening to us or they're complicit in our torture. The target's mind, they're hearing verbatim what you're saying, and thinking and hearing and smelling and sensing. The mental pain of being targeted, this is torture. I get loud synthetic telepathy in the privacy of my own home, with loved ones in public, during work and play. These attackers talk 24/7 against my will at me, questioning me with interrogation techniques that are used by the CIA. And they label it voice to skull or synthetic telepathy. And a learning computer with a synthetic voice that can be modulated in any voice can take over partially or full time. So, and then I'll just stop after I say this. Say the perps want to spend Christmas with their family, which has been the case the last 2 years. They'll put on a recorded thought and loop it into me.
Huh. Do you think that they are recording sexual information and selling it? This has come up several times, and I know that they are capable of recording a thought, or at least make you think that they do. Do you think that they're actually doing that and like selling it to people like paraplegics and that, I mean, don't have any action below the waist? What's your feeling?
I'll tell you my experience. And they are using R&M. It is a new technology. This is the truth. It's a technology being used against the human race as a weapon. it's pornographic at this point, and they're looping pornography and child abuse, sexual abuse of children and adults, and a rigorous homosexual subject. And this goes on nonstop. They actually recruit, and this is just in my hive. I hear them do this. They are exchanging each other's thoughts about pornography and having orgies. And they get viewers, and they are seducing TIs either to be a perp, or they are getting perps to join in the ranks with this kind of gang rape. And then they assault the TI and even other perps while they sleep. And it's viewed. They will gang rape us repeatedly. And as far as below the belt, now they're forcing me to choke, which means that one of them just says, "Marilyn, choke." And they've done it so much that that's my intro, so I believe I'm choking when I'm not. Yeah, below the belt. Yeah, they sell everything. They sell...
Okay, Marilyn, we have to go to station ID, and we'll be back in 3 minutes. I'd like to thank my audience. Thank you, Marilyn, and thank you for listening.
You are tuned in to the Republic Broadcasting Network. Visit our website by going to republicbroadcasting.org.
Tired of being lied to by mass media? It's growing more and more apparent today that news is received less and less through standard media outlets. Even with a growing audience every day, RBN is beginning to direct more efforts into social media. Social media and the use of the internet is fast becoming the primary source of people for news, regardless of demographic. RBN has set out to provide some of the best news on the internet through republicbroadcasting.org, and also has begun to use the tools to our advantage by way of social media. Republic Broadcasting is now operating a Facebook page to function as yet another avenue to have our collective voice reach new audiences across not only America, but across the globe as well. The Facebook page features not only news, but also an RBN player to listen to our broadcast. Get involved by visiting facebook.com/republicbroadcasting and liking our page and share it with your friends and family, because you can handle the truth.
How healthy are your arteries? Deteriorating circulation has a number of early warning signs. High cholesterol, high blood pressure, fingers and or toes often go cold, arms and or legs often go to sleep, sharp diagonal crease in the earlobe, short walks cause cramping or pains in legs, memory is not as good as it used to be, ankles swell late in the day, chest pain after physical exercise or emotional stress. If you experience even one of these symptoms, your circulatory system is crying out for attention. Extendivite is a natural solution to help improve your overall health. Extendivite is not your average heart tonic. To order, call 1-877-928-8822 or visit heartdrop.com or find us on Amazon.
Extend your life with Extendivite.
Homeowners, if your lender has gone out of business or sold your transaction to another lender or servicer, you may be the victim of a wrongful foreclosure resulting in the loss of your home. If you've already lost your home, are in foreclosure, or even in good standing, you can challenge the mortgage transaction's illegal issue and your property can be restored to you, and your foreclosure can be stopped or reversed and the mortgage transaction declared unenforceable. State laws, U.S. title codes, the Uniform Commercial Codes, and U.S. Supreme Court rulings have upheld that defective mortgage documentations can reverse or stop foreclosures and enforce property title claims in favor of the homeowner. We are having successes in stopping the process of foreclosure, the enforcement of the foreclosure judgments, the sale of property, and evictions after the sale. We are not attorneys, and we don't give legal advice. We are a professional team of legal researchers, providing forensic mortgage audits and expert witnesses. We have the knowledge to produce the evidence and enforce laws regarding your legal issues. We've been in business for 12 years without a complaint. Consultations are free, and we provide a free title search to confirm if your mortgage has legal defects. Please call 855-253-3748. 855-2, keep it today.
Can you hear me? Can you hear me running? Can you hear me running? Calling you. Can you hear me? Can you hear me running? Can you hear me running?
Good evening from Boston, Massachusetts. My name is Frank Allen. Tonight, Marilyn and I discuss our targeting on TM Radio. Okay, Marilyn, I just wanted to let you know that you parallel my targeting almost perfectly. And a lot of people will say that, oh, your targeting is not anything like mine. But people have to realize, okay, how many years have you been targeted? Okay, myself, I've been targeted a little over 8 years. So if somebody has been targeted 3 years, they might be in a different stage. Like the first stages of targeting for me were a form of gang stalking. And I will call it this because they made it, they dumped everything they had on me all at once. And what came out of that was paranoia. So I immediately thought everyone was out to get me. I went around rotaries 2 and 3 times. I saw one night, I was driving down this road and I became the road warrior. I didn't settle anywhere. And I saw this troop of probably 8 to 10 cars. They were all white and they were all taking a right turn in front of me. And I said, oh God, here we go. Here's the United States government falling in. But if I look back on it, it's probably driver ed school that was taking all their cars back home. So that's the way I look at it, but I overcame the paranoia and realized that when I walked into a store, everyone wasn't watching me. And, nobody was really following me. And that's what happened. So I just started to add a lot of logic to the situation and realized that, yeah, I was heavily targeted, but there wasn't anybody following me yet. So beware, because they can make you think or try and make you think just about anything. And if you're brand new to this, this is like a virgin brain for them, and they can dump anything at you. And I mean, when this first started, I pulled into a Dunkin' Donut and I literally took the interior of my car apart looking for bugs, and naturally there aren't any. Well, what do you think, Marilyn?
Yeah, the social control and the isolation can, and then with it, the weapons, can make you believe a lot of things that aren't true. Not everyone is after us. That's impossible. Not every neighbor is aware of your targeting. That's just impossible. And I'd even say not every mayor is aware of the program. The vehicular stalking that's being reported, I do believe that they are using this as a tactic. Brian, too, called it leapfrogging. And, you know, I, like a lot of TIs, the vehicular weaponry, where they take something as cool as a car and make you believe that it's a weapon against your life. Once you hear these engines and you see these cars and you're getting voices and you're shot with microwaves and ionized radiation and they're crippling you and poisoning you and there's chemtrails and there's 5G and the last thing you need to worry about is this damn vehicular stalking. The real deal is the two-way electronic brain link. And these weapons shot into our bodies, that these physical intimidations and the rumor spreading, falsified crime. 20 years I've been targeted about. It's been about 20 years.
I wanted to comment on that part where you said that this woman was picking up your song. Well, that's very logical, because especially in our current states of awareness, I'm not sure whether all human beings do it, but a lot of human beings, like a lot of targets, or probably all of the targets, broadcast. You are in broadcast mode. So someone else has just picked up what you are sending out, and you happen to have a strong mind, and you are sending this information out. And this is why I think many targets are targets, because they are broadcasters instead of wallflowers.
Oh, and the moment of truth is that if you've ever had an anxiety disorder or issues with fear, that I think the fear of knowing that your thoughts are broadcasted even into a crowd of people, once you can handle that, you're pretty much set. there's a lawsuit filed by a TI against the NSA, John Acquey versus the NSA, and Fort Meade, Fort George G. Meade, Maryland. So in this text, as it explains, this two-way electronic brain link is done by remotely monitoring neural, audio, visual information while transmitting sound to the auditory cortex, bypassing the ears and transmitting faint images to the visual cortex, bypassing the optic nerves and eyes. The images appear as floating 2D screens in the brain. Have you seen these images? Because I have, asleep and sometimes awake.
Sure. I can choose to see them or not see them. I can shut them off like a switch or look at them. You know, and most of the time, it's disgusting things anyway. And I mm-hmm. just shut them off. You know, I just don't see them. You know, I just, for some reason in my mind, I have a switch that says, oh, I'm not looking at that. You know, and, but I think most targets have a lot of the same mental attributes when it comes to reception and broadcasting, sending and receiving. And it means typically the person is outgoing, not withdrawn in any way, but an outgoing person who is, you know, continually through facial expression broadcasting how they feel. And with that goes the mental attributes go out with it. And this is what the perps play on. And you've given a very good example of that with that woman trying to sing your song, because that's exactly what you are. You're a broadcaster on your own long before targeting. And that's because the human race is actually evolving to the point that someday we would be able to communicate in that fashion. But you cannot force that type of communication on an organism of any type. But something as complicated as the human brain is definitely not ready for that. Someday,
no.
Yes.
You know, there's a couple things I want to say about the brain. I think your brain, if you're targeted, it's going to need an excessive amount of calories. It's being overstimulated and worked and forced to work and defend itself and defend you. But they get these psychopaths that are in our local community to stalk and torture us. And I periodically write down the things that I hear. And I'm going to give you a sense of what kind of perp I have. This woman named Keisha, she's black. She has a son. They just talk and talk and talk. That's how I know this. And she thought this in a discussion with someone else in the hive, that they questioned, you know, why are you a gang stalker and you have a kid? And why are you doing these sexual activities with your son there? And she said that daycare, end quote, that daycare bill is expensive, because she had her son in the other room while she was doing sexual acts for drugs on behalf of the hive. And another quote, we're selling Marilyn Page for crack. And, you know, they're given favors, drugs, crack, pizza, anything to just keep torturing me and bothering me. I don't even know who these people are. Do you journal, and do you think it's wise for TIs to kind of document what they're doing or saying, or when you get shot with a direct energy weapon?
Yes. I definitely think that it's a good idea to journal everything. Unfortunately, the, situation that I was in prompted me to leave everything behind. And I had to, once again. And those are some of the things that I really wish that I'd had with me today. But I don't. But yes, it is a good idea. And I don't
care. Well, one way.
Go ahead.
Okay. So I just want to say that one way that text messaging is a way to document this between TIs. And I say, oh, you know, if it's evidence on some level to me. So when you were shot in Boston in the eye with a laser, I transcribed the text. I was just looking at my journal to find the obscenities that are played out in my head. And I wrote down the time, too, just to let you know. That was in March, around March 22nd. I think that's when you were...
that long ago? Wow.
Mm-hmm. And I wrote it down. I was choked that day, too. And let's see. I documented that I spoke with another TI, and me and Kevin, the TI from L.A., talked about your eye. I wrote that down. You said you had a large clump floating around in your eye, interfering with your vision. There were darts of light as though they were chasing me around in my car. They have been totally nuts lately. I told you to get eye protection. And then I had let Kevin know that this happened to you. And so, yeah, my God, I mean, the city of Boston has terrorists shooting civilians with lasers. I mean, it doesn't get any more sick than this.
Yeah, I agree. 100%. That was the weirdest experience that has ever happened to me, because it actually happened like this. I looked up and I could feel an immediate change, and it sort of threw me back in the seat a little bit. And then all of a sudden, the car started to fill up with these white balls. And bigger than a golf ball, we'll say, like, they looked like bright white tennis balls. But I know what it is now after talking to the professionals. That's what happens when the you have a breach directly at the optic nerve. So the whole car filled up in my field of vision with these white balls. But I don't panic. No matter what. So I just waited until they diminished. And then I drove home. And when I got home, there were still two of them left in my eye. And they left and sort of like vanished or dimmed out or faded out. And that was the end of it. Then after that, must have been when I texted you about the big clumps. So, yeah, that is a good point. Texting is an excellent way of documenting things that have happened. Like tonight, when I texted you, I said, God, I've really been getting slammed. And I think that you had said that I think... one of the black perps was raping you or something like that, remote raping you, and you sent me those
right.
pictures.
So this neural weapon, your brains are connected, so you can feel each other's experiences. So yeah. What does the local contractor want to do with us? He wants to watch us get raped. And so I am being Natasha Williams. She's a psychotic child abuser. She makes child pornography for the gang stalking community. Not gang stalking community. The gang stalking terrorists. These fascist pigs who are anti-American, who are destroying our civil rights and breaking the law and ruining the Constitution. She is a sicko, and she's doing this repeatedly. I'm in the car at home. And she's, loving her privates and then concentrating on me. But it's grotesque. Pre-crime. Now, this is not being used for pre-crime because many of these people torturing us are sex offenders and criminals and drug dealers and murderers. They're recruiting the criminal class in our counties and attaching these psychopaths from the top to the bottom. It doesn't matter if it's the NSA or some local loser. But they fabricate false evidence to justify this program, and they call it crime prevention. And they fabricate evidence, and they falsify crime, and they spread rumors about the targeted individual discrediting us. And then usually it's accusing us of sex crimes so that when we are out, there's so-and-so. This is like a witch hunt. This is a military-grade witch hunt. I wonder, since these people are local, why do you think it's so hard to block these imbeciles, to get these people progressively locked in jail, the people not necessarily who use the weapons, but the local boots on the ground? What do you think we need to do to get these people put in prison?
It's going to take a lot of research on our part to find out where they are. I mean, to find out who they are, where they are, and track them down, and then sit on the house. Just hang on that house, stake it out. And after a while, I think you will see more targets come and more targets come, and it's going to make the perps flip. And that's what I think we should do. And there's no law against it. You're peacefully demonstrating on that particular street. That's all.
Right. And these people talking to you, some of them are real. Some of it is an AI or a computer program. But for the people that are having brain-to-brain communication, ask these people who they are. Ask their names. And these are the names that I have so far. Charles Miller, last name's Miller, female. Keisha, her last name might be Brown. Her mother's name is Deborah. Josh, no last name. And this list is just long, and I don't have one address. Michael Warden, definitely. He went to Roosevelt High School here in Dayton, Ohio. He's a 55-year-old crackhead. It's on the verge of 2020, and people are smoking crack during a crisis like this, an electronic war. Daryl Washington, various sodomites, anti-family, anti-God. Edward Hamilton, a 58-year-old psychopath who's a rapist and pedophile. This is what the deep state is recruiting to gang stalk Americans. Trash. And I've had it up to here. And I've spoken with Karen Stewart. I just want to read something from one of her expert writings. It says, hence, it would appear the intelligence community and the military-industrial complex that they were in bed with decided that a new enemy had to be created to feed the war machine and to make sure the well never ran dry. An endless war was declared on secret terrorists from a well-unending target, regular, unsuspecting citizens of the world, secretly declared terrorists without proof or even minimal probable cause. And this is after, 9/11 and that whole false flag. So that's my rant. I've had enough. the Fusion Centers, Marilyn Houston of Lockheed Martin, the satellite industry, the CEOs that run these satellite companies, those are our targets.
Right.
People conspiring against the privacy that our brains are not for sale. You do not break into the brain.
Yeah, we have a lot of issues. Now, I think I sent that quote to you about the skull. Well, the skull should be the boundary. That's the boundary layer. You never go beyond the skull. And I don't care what it's for. For a medical breakthrough, fine. We've done without it for hundreds of years. and we've come up with medical breakthroughs. So, you know, stay out of people's minds, because, you know, they steal, your perps have probably stolen portraits from you. They've stolen, you know, you have no idea probably the amount of data they have actually taken from you, because you're a very talented artist, and you still owe me a portrait too, by the way.
You got it. Exactly. I do owe you a portrait. And we are still here. We are still alive. And we should be able to enjoy some things. And art is one of the, you know, the great things about being a human in this civilization. I have a quote. I could read it real fast. The skull should be designated as a domain of absolute privacy. No one should be able to probe an individual's mind against their will. We should not permit it with a court order. We should not permit it for military or national security. We should forgo the use of the technology under the coercive circumstances thought using it may serve the public good. Frank Allen. I think I quoted you correctly.
Yeah. And it's... I just couldn't fathom, you know, when I was growing up, and I used to see things on mind control. In fact, my best friend went to this mind control class to try and, you know, better your thinking. And they were telling him that he could program a parking space at next time he went shopping, you know. But so that was kind of like BS. But what I remember about it is very little. And unfortunately, that's what the general public remembers. And we're starting to awaken the general public to the idea that, okay, this is very real. And you have to get ready for this. And there are so many that are probably targeted that don't know it. Oh, wow, we're running almost over. Okay, we have to say goodnight, Marilyn.
Good night, Frank.
Good night. Good night from Boston, Massachusetts. My name is Frank Allen.
The reviews for Extendivite are amazing. Here are some from Amazon. By Christine, great for heart palpitations. By Anne, before I started using this product, every afternoon, my ankles and my hands would be swollen. That doesn't happen anymore. So if that part of their advertising is true, I have to assume that the rest of it is also. Not to mention that when I had my yearly blood test, only a few weeks after beginning to use this product, my cholesterol had dropped over 30 points. I'm going to continue to take it. By Croc, I love this product. It really works. By Brad, works great. Thank you. Tell us your story. Get your Extendivite today. To order, call 1-877-928-8822. That's 1-877-928-8822. Or visit heartdrop.com.
Extend your life with Extendivite.
You're listening to the Republic Broadcasting Network, because you can handle the truth.